new soap in the shave den by Artisan I've been wanting to try for a long, long time. Stay tuned.
I'm Miss Floridian, but I gotta tell you something. I saw this soap, Shark Bite, on the counter, and I was like, those are so cute. What does this smell like? So I smelled it, and I love it so much. I want to like eat this. I wanna eat this. And I'm telling you, 345 Soap Company, I need this in a body butter, body wash, and lip gloss by Christmas, please. Because this man does not know, and he is not gonna be happy when he finds out that I've been using his post-shave balm, whatever this stuff is. I don't even know, what is it? Post-shave balm as a body lotion. It smells so good. So 345 Soap Company, make it happen. Let's get this stuff in lip gloss and body lotion, all sorts of stuff. I gotta go. Here it comes. I gotta go.
Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, Brian the Floridian, coming to you from the shave den. Now I'm back for a shave. I've got about 2 days worth of growth in my face and pretty excited to have a new mail call I've been wanting to try out from this artisan that's been around since 2019. I believe they started making soaps, I want to say last year in 2020, but anyway, the soap I'm going to use is right, it was right here. Hang on 1 second. All right, there it is. Yeah, my shave stuff's been moved around, so kind of weird. But anyway, guys, want to try this out. This is called Shark Bite by 345 Soap Company. So anyway, 345 Soap Company, the artisans behind them, behind this company is John and Anna Patton, and they've been making soaps, bar soaps, I believe, shaving soaps, I want to say candles also, since 2019. And if I'm not mistaken, I think they started making shaving soap last year in 2020. But anyway, I've been wanting to try this company out. Been seeing like a lot of people doing Shave of the Days reviews on the 345 soaps, and I've heard they are amazing. But anyway, guys, been wanting to do this for a while, try this company out. And I saw this just came out recently, so I believe last month or last month and a half, and I just jumped on it because I wanted a nice summer soap, and this one just screams, man, just screams beach, ocean, summer. I mean, this one, if you can put summer in a shave soap, this would be it. And this is amazing, the scent. It is very, very nice. I just love this scent. I mean, my whole bathroom smells just like Shark Bite. But man, whew, man, I've been wanting to try this. I've heard a lot of good stuff about this soap. And I've been hearing like a lot of good words about their other soaps too. White Buffalo, Red Cabin in the Woods. I think they make a few soaps. Not a whole lot, but they've been making a few soaps and releasing them every so often, like every month or 2 months, and releasing their soaps to I believe their website and also on the razor company they have. They carry their stuff too. But anyway, guys, this will be my shave, Shark Bite by 345 Shave Company or Soap Company. And I'm gonna be using a shark theme. So I'm gonna be using my RazoRock Stainless Steel Jaws. This is a 0.68 open comb razor. Probably one of my best razors I have in my shave den. And I have to use this razor with this shave because this just goes with a theme. And I'll be using this paired with a first time use the blade, shark blade. Gotta go with a shark blade with this razor. With a shark. Shit.
need a bigger boat.
And this is the stainless steel version, the stainless blade version of this blade. And I'm gonna be using my Maggard's brush. This is the gray synthetic. I wanna say it's called the gray wolf knot, but just a beautiful brush. I love this Maggard's brush. I almost said RazoRock, but this is actually Maggard's with the distinctive maple leaf on the end of it. Just a beautiful brush. I love this knot. Very, very nice backbone, very soft. So, ready for the shave. Let me get into the shave, guys. Let me go wash my face, get ready, get my face fully hydrated, and I'll be right back. All right, guys, I'm back for my first pass, my first face lather. I actually took a little bit of the soap out of the tub and put it into my shave bowl, and I did a brush lather loading, and wasn't expecting this. Look at all this lather. So it's like I did a bowl lather, which I was really trying to get the soap on to the brush, but pretty amazing lather right off the bat. So I think this is gonna be a great soap. Let me go do that first face lather here. And off the bat, big explosion. Yeah, definitely a big explosion of this scent. Very, very nice. Definitely fruity. Beachy. Man, it smells nice. But man, look at that lather. So I was reading the website. The Artisan, which is John and Anna, they actually made this soap. They put like a lot of good stuff in this soap. A lot of different oils, butters. Also, they used donkey milk, I believe. It says camel and goat milk. So they use a lot of different types of milk as butters, and they just want to make the soap as this soap base as shave friendly as possible, or as amazing as possible, which it seems to be right now. Look at this lather. But the intent was to make it so good that you wouldn't need a pre-shave with this soap, and kind of have to agree with them. It's really, really, really nice lather. Let me do that first pass and see how well this soap does shave without a pre-shave, which I really don't use my pre-shave except my cube, but I want to see if there's any difference between this and using my cube as I do with other soaps. Anyway, guys, this is the first use of the blade, the shark blade in the Jaws. Going with the shark theme here. And so far, wow, nice and slick. Yeah, very slick. Not much drag at all, so. I like it that these artisans are being creative with using different ingredients to improve their soaps. The donkey milk and camel milk, that is a different. I don't think I have any soaps with that stuff, with camel milk or donkey milk included, except this one right here. But plenty of goat milk soaps I tried in the past. Great, great formulas. But that was a nice pass on this side. Yeah, very slick. So the butters they have in their soaps, I was reading, they have mango. They include a couple ones I really can't pronounce. Meru Meru butter. That's what they use also. They use cocoa, capricol. That's another word I'm not really familiar with. But they mix all that together with their different oils. And from what I hear, they came up with this amazing base, which people are just saying is one of the best ones on the wet shaving community, or in the wet shaving world. But the scent, man, the scent is nice. It just basically floats everywhere in the bathroom. Very nice, fruity, coconut. I think the scent notes I have written down over here, they include pineapple, pear, coconut, and woods. So definitely a huge splash of the fruit right off the bat. And you do kind of, it kind of does run out with the woods at the end a little bit. But more so of the pineapple and the coconut, that really comes out in the soap. But man, look at this nice lather, nice slickness here. Yeah, this razor is amazing too, by the way. Not a very aggressive razor, probably about more toward the middle range or in terms of mildness or aggression. I mean, not bad for an open comb, so it's not really aggressive. But most people think when they see open combs like this, they think they're gonna be really aggressive, but man, this razor is not aggressive. It is absolutely perfect for someone like me with sensitive skin. I love this razor. I think Joe at RazoRock makes incredible razors for decent prices, for value prices, especially their stainless steel offerings like this and the Game Changer. Also the Lupo, I haven't tried that one yet, but I'm gonna get that hopefully soon. But definitely Joe is making some great razors out there. All right guys, that's the first pass. Pretty nice pass, very slick. I mean, I can tell the soap is amazing just by feeling my skin, nice and soft. Still pretty slick. I mean, I can still feel the slickness on my face even without, you know, without the lather being there. But anyway guys, let me go over some face and I'll be back for the second pass. All right guys, second face lather, second pass. First pass was amazing. I really enjoyed that first pass. That was a nice first pass lather with that soap. The scent is amazing. I just can't say enough for the scent. I just love this scent. Definitely screams summer. Like I said, I've been saying that. I know throughout the whole video, but man, this one definitely screams summer. And this would probably be a nice scent to put in a fragrance or cologne. Especially if you want to wear this to the beach. So just a idea there, John and Anna Patton, if you guys want to put this in a cologne, it probably would work. And speaking about John and Anna Patton, they're from Northern Colorado, so for them to get this beachy summer vibe and this soap to get it right from a couple of people that live in that area of the country, They definitely got it right. This is pretty amazing. So since they're not, I would imagine not too many beaches up there in that area of Colorado. All right guys, that's the first, actually the second face out of here. Let me go and do that second pass across the grain with the shark blade and the jaws. So Shark Week is actually July 11th, but I didn't want to wait that long to do this shave because I want to do it with this soap. For you guys who don't know what Shark Week is, they basically have programming for a whole week. National Geographic, I believe, the Travel Channel. What else? What other channels? There's a few other channels that do a shark themed programming for that week, and it's every year, so it's pretty cool. A lot of people are actually big fans of that. They actually like to sit there and watch shark stuff all week long. Being in Florida, I see that stuff all the time, just going to the different aquariums here, even going fishing. Sometimes you catch sharks. So Shark Week is pretty much happening down here in Florida almost every day or every week, depending on where you live here in Florida. And I'm praying that the jaws doesn't bite me, because it's never really used it with the sharp blade, so. The first pass was great. No nicks yet. I think I spoke too soon. I got one right there. Just now, I just got a nick from that last pass, so. So I can tell my wife, if she really loves my soaps, which ones, because I find them sometimes moved around in the bathroom here. Sometimes I find them, like, I have soaps hanging off this door back here. And my favorite, her favorite ones sometimes are kind of like put here on the counter here, you know, right here on the counter for me to use, because that's what she wants me to use, because she likes that scent. So just this one being moved around a little bit, I knew she would love this one. All right, that was a nice pass. No, just that one nick right there from the shark blade from the jaws, but not bad. Let me go and rinse my face, guys, and I'll be right back. All right, back for my last final pass here. Final face leather. Yeah, you really don't need to do a pre-shave with this soap. This soap is amazing. Nice and slick. Yeah, I would go as far as to say probably, if you're using this soap, you probably don't even need to do a shower before you do a shave. Like a lot of soaps, I do like a pre-shave shower just to soften the hairs. But man, this soap, I can probably wash my face and use this soap and get away with a good shave without any nicks. That's how good the soap is. I can tell right now how, just by those first two passes, that this is amazingly slick. So definitely becoming a fan of this soap. Man, there's so many good artisans out there. So many good ones. This one is great. Hub City is great. Moon Soaps. I mean, all these new ones coming out, they're making some great, amazing soap bases here. And I'm a fan of 345 so far. Even after just two passes. Guys, let me go against the grain here. So hope you guys are doing well. It's been really hot here in Florida. But no more love bugs. Love bug season is finally gone, so don't have to do the daily wash of my car every time I go down the road and come back home. I think hurricane season officially started like this week, so after love bug season, there's hurricane season here in Florida. But definitely the rains have been here. The rain's been raining almost every afternoon here. So typically Florida weather starts off really nice early in the morning till about 2 o'clock. It's very nice, nice and sunny, clear blue skies. Then out of nowhere, just all the clouds move in, the rain clouds. It'll just rain for about an hour or 2 hours, and they'll be nice again. So it's kind of weird. Even what's strange is, like, sometimes it'll be standing. See, you know, for example, standing on one side of the road, it'll be raining on that side where you're staying at. The other side will be nice and sunny. So it's kind of weird Florida weather we have here. Typical for Florida. Yeah, going from one extreme to the other, pretty much with the weather here. Kind of weird. All right, guys, do that underneath here. Nice and slick. This soap is nice and slick. Oops. Oh, the shark bit me right here. Or actually, the jaws bit me. Yeah, other than that, man, nice shave. Man, look at that, that is a bleeder. I just opened up another cut that I had here from my other straight razor shave I did a few days ago on my own here off camera, but man, yep, that's definitely a bleeder. Anyway, guys, I'll be back for the post shave after I get this cut under control, and I'll be right back. All right, guys, back for the post shave. How did I get this cut under control? I cut myself with a straight razor shaving recently, and I opened it up with this thing again. So, like I said, this is not an aggressive razor, but man, if you're not paying attention, any razor can cut you. So definitely, just to show you that if you're not paying attention or if you're not being conscientious of where you cut yourself before last time, you will cut yourself again, even with a mild razor. But anyway, guys, post-shave, I'll be using this is a Shark Bite 345 Shave Balm. Unfortunately, I couldn't get a hold of the splash because it was out of stock. So I got the next best thing, which was a Shave Balm. And from looking at their website on 345 Shave and Razor, the Razor Company, a lot of their stuff, it just comes and goes pretty quick. So definitely they have a big, huge following. Great products. Great products tend to have a good following and tend to sell pretty quick. So definitely, if you see it or want to try it, get your hands on it, I would definitely pull the trigger right away because this stuff will be gone. But I want to try, this is a shave balm. I wanted to try one of their post-shave, either the balm or the splash, so I settled for the shave balm. So let's go ahead and try this out. And this is a very nice scent also. A little bit, maybe even a little bit stronger than the soap, but it's like a lotion almost. It's right there, kind of like a lotion. And I'm gonna take a little bit off the lid right here. About that much. Put it in my hands like so, and then probably got a little bit too, maybe a little bit too much, but man. Yeah, like I said, like a huge splash punch to the face of fruit, pineapple, and yeah, pear, coconut. That's what you get when you put this stuff on your face. A huge punch of that stuff right in the face. Very, very nice. And the woods coming out is right toward the end. The woods does come out. It's the base note, so I believe it's their base note, so it does come out toward the end. But great stuff. Not too oily. Yeah, pretty light. A pretty nice lightweight shave balm. And kind of refreshing actually too. It's not too, definitely doesn't sting at all. There's no alcohol in the shave balm. And yeah, not too light. I mean, not too heavy. Just about right. I love the shave balms that are just light, not too oily. And this one fits the bill. Anyway, guys, that's my shave. And I'm digging this stuff. Really digging it. Love the Shark Bite. Love the 345 Soap Company soap. At least this one right now. I gotta try some more of these products. These are getting a lot of buzz, and I can see why. Great soap base, great scent. And if you see this one, a great summer soap, grab it because it's a great deal. $16.95 for 5.8 ounces. That comes out to be like $2.92 per ounce for soap. For a pretty reasonable tub of soap, 5.8 ounces. That's pretty reasonable for shaving soap. Great, especially a base like this. Pretty unique, very very shave friendly base, and I would definitely recommend this soap. This is a great soap. Probably anything from 345. So I'm not sure what the other scents smell like, but I'm guessing they'll probably be amazing too. Also. So this is my shave with this soap. Use the Aftershave Balm, which is also nice. And I think this is like around, this wasn't expensive either. This is like less than $15, I think. Very, very reasonable. And I use that for my shave. I use the RazoRock Jaws 0.68 plate with the wide gap. Look at that, look at the teeth there. Those teeth definitely did a good job biting my, right here, causing that that bloodletting there I just showed you a minute ago. For my previous cut, and I used the Shark Blade, so that was the first use of the blade in that razor. I don't think I ever used a Shark Blade in that razor, so this is my first time using this blade in that razor. So definitely a nice blade. I don't use these very often, but they are great blades. The stainless steel ones are good. I think they're like probably my top 10 blades to try that I'd like to try. Not top five, but man, these are decent blades. And they're cheap too also. I think these are like, I see these occasionally for around $6 for 100 blades on Amazon on different websites. So definitely a great value blade to get. And last but not least, use the Maggard's Gray Wolf Knot Synthetic Brush. Nice brush, one of my favorite brushes to use. I just love that little maple leaf there. Anyway guys, that's my shave. Hope you guys enjoy your shaves. Hope you guys enjoy using your products this summer. Getting ready for summer it's gonna be hopefully better than last year. But hope you guys are doing well. Hope you guys are enjoying yourselves and staying safe. And I'll see you guys later. Take care.